Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a rainy Midland Community Stadium here for tonight's Dow High Charger homecoming game. The Chargers are hosting the Bay City Western Warriors in homecoming tonight. The Chargers looking to remain perfect on the season, coming in at 5-0. And this is Dave Marsh along with the old ball coach Frank Aldemore bringing you all the action tonight. And the coach, rainy night. On paper, Dow High has got a distinct edge. But as we come into this, Bay City Western will be ready for the game. And then will the weather be a factor in this game, do you think?
I think the weather will be a factor, but not as much as most people would think. First off, we have a good field.
Yeah.
So usually weather affects the field. We have an artificial turf, so it may be a little slippery, but not bad. We also have a Bay City team that has not produced at all this year. They are, as we can see, last in offense in their league. They are third in defense, and really not a bad defensive team, but they just do not have the offense. They do not run the football. They do not throw the football like a lot of good teams do. And consequently, their record is 2-3, and the two teams they defeated, they were both close games against teams that had not won a game. So on paper, this should be Dow's game. But the weather could be a factor, and a lot of it depends on what decision the coaches make on how they're going to cover Dow's prolific offense. And to tell you the truth, Dave, if it was me, it'd be interesting seeing this. I would be in a three-deep zone and defy Dow to throw the ball because I'm hoping for tip balls, overthrown ball. When the ball is wet, anything can happen. So here we go to the keys of the game, and this is for the Chargers, first off, attack that secondary. We're talking about every one of Dow's starting receivers are over 6 foot. Every one of Western's defenders are under 6 foot. They're 5'7", 5'8". So you have a height advantage plus, as I said, an outstanding passing game. So attack that secondary. Dow, again, has to have strong defensive line play. The key to Western has been being able to run the football. And finally, for them, for Dow to force turnovers. For Bay City Western, slow the game down. Just 30 seconds every time. Pressure the quarterback. Try to get the quarterback to move his feet a little bit and give up because of that. Give up the run game. And finally, a field position game. Don't be afraid to punt the ball and force Dow to run the field.
Well, you mentioned the Chargers coming in with a just having a phenomenal season in their five wins. They're 5-0 overall, 4-0 in the Saginaw Valley League. The Charger defense has only allowed 34 points on the year. Meanwhile, have racked up 207 points offensively. And very balanced attack on offense. Dow High coming in with 923 yards rushing, 930 passing. And so have really done a good job of that balanced attack. And they're led, of course, by the senior quarterback, Bruce Mann, who was had a tremendous season last year in leading Dow to the playoffs. And he's has not missed a beat. In fact, he may have even improved as we see the Chargers running onto the field. Bruce Mann with 12 touchdown passes, only one interception, over 900 yards passing, completes 62% of his passes.
The biggest problem has been that they've jumped off to so many big leads that really they've had the running clock in the second half for most games, which means you're going to be limited in your throwing because you're going to try to run the game off. And he's been limited in that respect, which consequently affects a person's stats.
Yeah,
but he's got it. He's got the arm, and he's got the receivers again. Big, tall basketball players.
And Dow High needing the win tonight, a victory tonight, will put him at 6-0 and clinch another playoff berth for Coach Jason Watkins' squad.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
And we are going to send it on down to the field here. It's Dow High Pep Band. We'll be playing the national anthem tonight. We'll be right back. to the Dow High Pep Band. And Coach, you mentioned, I commend the band. This is a rainy night, and a lot of times it's tough for the band to come out with their sweat and everything. And so I commend the band for coming on out and support the team here for this homecoming game.
Well, homecoming is such a big night, and to have the rain ruin it is it's a real shame.
Yeah.
Too bad.
Definitely has affected the crowd here tonight. But people are streaming in, and you can see the Dow High Chargers, they are fired up. The rain is certainly not affecting their mindset coming in. They have just looking to keep the train rolling here tonight. We mentioned Dow High coach Jason Watkins has just been done a phenomenal job coaching and just looking to keep it rolling here tonight against a Bay City Western squad that is 2-3 overall, 2-2 in the Saginaw Valley League. Have struggled scoring points, only 46 on the year through five games, and has allowed 161. And so we'll start off with the Bay City Western doing the kickoff honors, and the Chargers will get the ball first for this contest. Yeah, you look at the running attack for Dow High. Moise Guerrier is the leading rusher. You'll see him at number 20, 359 yards, averaging over 8 yards a carry. Mann, we had mentioned, he's their number two rusher at 343 yards. He scored 3 touchdowns. Those two have done the bulk of the ball carrying. And we are underway, a squib kick, and it'll go out of bounds. And a flag on the very first play. They certainly tried to keep it away from the return men of the Chargers. And ball sailed out near the 30, so.
Well, I kind of thought they were going to do a somewhat of a low-line drive like mm-hmm. that and hope that they're going to be able create a turnover. And Dow is asking them to, nope, it's going to go out to the 40.
There's a
should be at the 35.
Little confusion. The,
yeah, there
the
it
chain
is.
Crew had it right. The chain crew had it set on the 35. Initially, they were putting the ball on the 40, but correctly put at the 35-yard line. Spencer Stevenson, senior, number 34 in the backfield with Bruce Mann. Jacob will be in action. Fumble on the first play, but Mann gets possession, throws downfield, a wide open receiver. It's caught. It's going to be a first down on the very first play. Austin Stredney on the reception, number 84. He's 6'3". You mentioned Dow, very tall team, a tall receiving core. Good poise by Mann.
Good poise by Mann.
And Stredney hauls it in. It's his 18th catch on the season for Stredney. Well, in Western territory, Mann back fires downfield again, and it's caught. That's Cook still on his feet. Oh, what a move. What a job by Cook, and he's going to go down at the one, and he fumbles it, but I think he was down. The official is going to say he was down. So Mann finds Brendan Cook on the play. And what a job
there's an example,
after the catch.
There's an example of what we're talking about. You have a tall receiver who goes up, missed tackles in the secondary. This has been Bay City Western's big problem. That is tackling with in space. And they just do not do a very good job of it.
So ball all the way down to the 1 yard line.
This is gonna be Stevenson.
Another fumble off the snap. And this time he, Mann retrieves it, but he's gonna lose yardage back to the 4. They'll bring up a second and goal from the 4. Second time he's had trouble corralling the snap. I don't know if that's from the slick ball or just a little over anxious there
at the start of the game. It's a slick ball.
Mann, 6'3", 210, senior quarterback.
so when we transition, so we're still in camera.
Stevenson will take the handoff, and he is swarmed under, nowhere to run. 53, Brody Lewis on the stop.
Very good defensive stand there by Western.
Now the ball's back to the eight. Started on the one and lost three, then lost four.
Well, so usually this is a good sign. You know, give you a little bit of room to operate.
It could be in this case.
He needs a little room to operate.
Guerrier and Stevenson in the backfield. Fake the handoff, a slant, and he's got his man. Beautifully thrown ball. It's Joe Fabiano. Touchdown Chargers, just what you're talking about, Coach. You gave him that little extra room.
A quick slant
or post in the end zone, and man, on the money, hits Fabiano. Just like that, takes no time at all.
Well, two catches by Brandon Cook really made a difference. In both times, he just went up and reached up, took the ball away from the defenders, and with very little resistance.
And it'll be Ashton Brooks, number 14, will line up for the extra point. Stradney with the hold. And it's blocked. It was a bad snap. Pretty good job by the holder, but threw off the timing. And Dow will settle for that 6-point lead. And did not take long, Coach, for that vaunted Charger offense to strike.
Well, give all that credit to Mann, because he threw three good passes in that series. Three beautiful passes. The touchdown pass was absolutely perfect. Right on the money. The defender was right there, but again, a 6'2 defender on a 5'7 defender, a 6'2 receiver on a 5'7 defender. It's just an absolute mismatch.
Fabiano is 6'2. His third catch out of the year and his third touchdown. When he catches it, Fabiano makes it count.
Do you think maybe they should throw to him more?
Maybe. Maybe.
I mean, there's a pattern there. You kind of think about it.
Caleb Brudo, the kicker for Dow. And it's fumbled on the 16. But a pretty good job returning by Ryan Miller, Jr. And decent field possession for Bay City Western out to the 30-yard line.
Excellent tackle by Spencer Stevenson.
Stevenson is a beast out there.
Yes, he is. He's an outstanding. He's probably the best linebacker in the league, either side, red or blue.
Stevenson, inside linebacker, along with number 44, Connor Moe. First and 10, Warriors. Handoff. And swarmed under. It was the ball carrier was Liam Tobin, number 15. Ryan Miller is the quarterback for Bay City Western.
Bay City Western's only rushed for 272 yards in four games, or five games. So that's not very good.
Actually, David Coffey, the quarterback, hands it off. Strung out very nicely by the Charger defense.
Now, see, to me, that is a play that that coaches see on television and they like it because the guy running it is 4-4. But when a guy running it here is 5-5 in the 40, yeah, you're just going to – it's not a very good play. I don't know the fascination for the jet sweep because you have to have speed and you have to have blockers on the edge. And when you have neither of those, you're in trouble.
We'll bring up a 3rd and 10 for Bay City Western. David Coffey, the quarterback. 4 TD passes on the year. Swings it out, but it'll pick up about 5, but it won't be nearly enough for the first down. And he was brought down by Ben Zeitler. And he's Zeitler, the junior, and it'll bring up 4th down, a punting situation. Dow should get pretty good field position here following this punt. Austin Stradney will do the punt return honors. pretty heads-up play by Stredney there. There was a man going to be unblocked. He was arranging the blocking in front of him. Punt will trickle out of bounds at the 41-yard line. A punt by Justin Schaefer, sophomore kicker, and Dow High will take over with really good field position again at their own 41-yard line.
Again, one of my keys to the game here, and this is really for Western, but they don't seem to be listening to it. It's a field position game. You got to force Dow to run the length of the field. You can't give them the ball on the 41-yard line, the 35-yard line, because they're just going to take advantage of you.
So the receiver motion man back to pass again. He rolls to the right, surveys the field, floats it, throws it away, really. He was under heavy pressure. Good coverage downfield by the Warriors. Bring up a second and 10. Pretty good job by man there. You know, just play wasn't there. And instead of forcing something in your own territory, throw it out of bounds and give yourself another shot. The front line for Dow High, the offensive line, Aaron Reardon, number 51. Cesar Gonzalez, number 74. Ryan Mary is number 53. Also have Kevin Murray, 6'4", 220. He's number 70. Second and 10. Fires downfield, and it's almost picked off. Probably should have been. The ball sailed a little bit on man, and 41, Brendan Bellinger, had a great shot at that, but that slick ball, I think, just went through.
Well, just like I said earlier, you know, just sit back, allow them to throw the ball underneath, make the tackle. Eventually, they're going to throw one through somebody's hand or float it out there. And that's exactly what you get tonight. You don't get the sharp pass, you get the floater. And we've seen this in the series here.
Third and 10 for Dow High. Stevenson in the backfield alongside of Mann. And that's Fabiano in motion. Mann back to pass, looks left and fires right. Got his man, and it's very close to the first down. It'll depend on the spot, and was completed to Stredney, and they're going to say it's just short. I mean, just short. Less than half of a yard, and it looks like Coach Watkins is going to go for it. I think the officials are going to measure here. This is worthy of a measurement.
Well, the spot was not the best.
Talk about the offensive line for Dow. Shane Oskovarek also up front for the Chargers, providing protection for man and the rest of the offense. This is kind of an odd coach because they put the ball on the hash mark in the middle of the field, and then they moved it back to the
sideline.
So it could change from there.
And it's inches. As so, I say, Dow did not get the benefit of the spot.
This is a pretty good situation to go for it, I think.
Oh, yeah, this is.
You have a big, strong quarterback, even if he sneaks it. You got strong running back in Stevenson. I wouldn't even be shocked if they play action pass to here. Oh, this is, they're in the. Man taking his time till the chains are set. Two receivers out wide to the left. I think we may see Stevenson here. Nope, he's gonna sneak it. And he got the surge, first down. It's a great call. Pretty low risk play there.
Very, very good call. You have a 6'2", 200 plus ton quarterback.
We're gonna stop him on that.
No. And especially when you're in a four-man line, nobody over the center. I mean, that's,
hey, giving it to
football 101. Don't give them the quarterback sneak. Yeah. You know, and this is a problem with Western. They do some things that we just don't see. I mean, you got a big guy over to center now, and he wasn't there before.
First and 10 Chargers at the Western 46. Man, looking downfield. He's going to take off and run, and he's hauled down. He's going to pick up about 5 yards. Good decision there, but a nice defensive play by Brody Lewis for Bay City Western. So effective first down play, picking up 5 yards. You can see why Dow would be a very tough team to defend. Quarterback that can run it, good decision maker. You got some power in the backfield. We haven't even seen Guerrier run the ball yet, and he's their leading ball carrier. Man, back to pass, under pressure, breaks loose. Goes left, he's gonna fire downfield, and this one is almost picked off again. Intended for Cook, and it was nearly picked off by Mitch Myers.
Cook did a good job of breaking that up.
Again, yeah, he did.
We're seeing floating passes, you know, just we're not seeing the sharpness.
It's like we mentioned, it's a steady rain, and it's going from right to left. The rain's kind of going sideways, a pretty stiff breeze. It's at man's back this quarter. So the ball may be causing it to sail on him a little bit. Bring up a 3rd and 5 for Dow High. You just almost get the sense that they're, if they don't get it on 3rd, they may still go for it. Depends on the outcome of this play. Man back to pass. Under heavy rush is a screen to Stevenson. He's got it, and he pulls his way ahead for the first down.
Great
Once
effort.
He got ahead of steam, he was not going to be denied. And the defender
is going to get up slow.
Took a punishment.
he took a hit.
Yeah.
Great call by Dow coaching staff. Perfect time for the screen.
And Stevenson in space there. He's going to get 5 yards. He's just a load. 6'1", 220. Two-way player. He's also the long snapper for the Chargers. 1st and 10 at the 34. That's Syriac in motion. Inside screen to Cook, and he does a good job running after the catch. Just kind of picks his way for another Charger first down.
Bruce Mann's pass complete to number 4, Brendan Cook.
Now, one of the things that in coaching that you understand is that when it's wet, you got to make all your plays early because the ball is going to be shot by the second half. There's going to be a lot of footballs used, but they're all going to be wet and sloppy, and you may have to go to run game because it's hard to grip.
Just under 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Dow in complete command so far. Stevenson drives ahead. He got a hole, just plows ahead for about 9. Had a nice hole there. And then, he gets ahead of steam. Somebody's going to take some punishment to bring him down.
And if we take a look at Bay City Western, sometimes when you're getting beat up, as the game goes on, the team starts to get to you, you kind of let it go. You know, you don't have that, okay, we're a good team, don't worry about it, come back again. Right now I can see Bay City Western's kind of got their head down a little bit and their hands are on their knees. It's way too early for that.
Yeah. Still 6-0 game. Guerrier on his first carry. He's going to get the first down inside the 10. Bring up a first and goal from the 8 for Dow High.
Ball carry by number 20. Maurice for the Chargers. Picks up the first down, first and goal on the 8. Brought down by number 50.
Another first down for Dow High. They just have pounded the ball forward. Man, back to pass. Play action pass over the middle. Touchdown, Dow High.
Touchdown, Chargers.
Same play as the first touchdown, just a little slant. Austin Stradney this time, 6'3", 170-pound senior. Wide open over the middle of the field. And the Chargers, just like that, Bruce Mann with his second TD pass of the game, 14th on the season.
Again, you have mismatches that are occurring in that secondary. And great play action.
And wow, what a job by the kicker. Oh my gosh. Ashton Brooks, the snap was mishandled. Somehow he got it set up, and Brooks was usually a kicker gets thrown off, and he drilled it.
Well, the thing is, the Bay City Western guys completely stopped and said, no, okay, you
it's
can't
not gonna
kick
happen.
This.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's going to pick it up and run with it, and he kicked it.
There's the replay of the touchdown. And we seem to like that. It get about 8 yards and plenty of room to operate. And man with the touchdown pass. Stedney, his third touchdown reception on the season. He averages 11.3 yards per carry coming in, or per catch coming in. Dow High on top 13-0 with 3:45 remaining in the first quarter. Enthusiastic pep band braving the elements tonight.
It's going to be interesting to see now what Western's going to do. Again, it's a short kick.
Handle
this time.
And not a bad return by Ryan Miller out to the about the 31. Dow High has been in total control so far. Two lengthy touchdown drives. Meanwhile, Bay City Western has run three plays, had a three and out, had a punt. We'll see if they can muster any yardage here. Off tackle and not much doing there. Tackle made by Lance Johnson, senior, 5'11", 225 on the defensive front for Dow. Alex D'Amico, 77, also on the defensive front. Chargers. Pietro Finn, outside linebacker, number 50. Garrett Johnson, a defensive lineman for the Chargers as well. Another quick handoff and nowhere to run.
It's quite a swarming defense by the Chargers there.
That was D'Amico meeting the ball carrier in the backfield. And he's going to lose yardage back to the 30. Third and 11. It's going to be tough to go on third and long into the rain and wind here. In a clear passing situation. For the Warriors, looking for a way to score big in a clear. 44 Grant Fry split way to left for the Warriors.
Well, first off, the quarterback cannot throw the ball that far in this weather. So don't even bother covering him.
Back to
he's
going to
try.
And he throws it short, incomplete.
This is exactly what I was
about.
You just can't throw it that far in this weather. First off, you have to have an arm to do that.
Well, you got to be able to grip
there,
it.
And you got to be able to grip
ball.
It, throw it, and the ball just floats out there.
Play was there. It was open.
That's a touchdown the other way if in another situation.
So three and out for Bay City Western. Schaefer back to punt. Again for Western. Stredney deep to receive for Dow High. Stredney having a terrific first quarter for Dow. Oh, and he kind of shanks it, and it's going to go, gets a good roll, but it's about a 13-yard punt.
Again, field
to the
position.
43.
This is the kind of night for the rugby kicker.
Yeah,
you know,
where you do that.
Just trying to get it or it rolls over and
Yeah, he's kicking into a stiff wind. Looks like the rain may have subsided a little bit here. 1:57 to go in the first quarter. Dow High on top, 13-0. Looking for more. Two receivers out to the right. Two wide left. Stevenson in the left slot. Man, back to pass. He's under pressure. Elude still under pressure. Trying to get away, and he tripped up, and it's going to be fumbled out of bounds. Great defensive play by Grant Fry. He tripped him up. Man, as he was going down, fumbled. We'll bring a second and long. And I think contending that he threw the ball. But I think if that was a pass, it's probably intentional grounding.
Yeah,
so
I would say take the
better off being
take
a fumble.
Because
he
thought,
actually gained yardage.
See, I thought he was down before.
Back about 5 yards
earlier. So take this and accept it.
Second and 19. Man, back to pass. It's a little screen, and it's dropped. Boy, he had room to run, too. That was Stredney. Well set up screen. He was going to catch it in a full sprint. They like that little inside screen. It worked for a first down earlier in the quarter, and it was there then. So third and 19 with a minute and a half to go in the quarter. Dow High cheerleaders cheering on their team. This is a big play for the Western defense.
They need a stop.
Man, over the middle, and it's broken up. They're going to throw the flag. Oh, boy, I don't know about that. That ball, I'm not sure that was catchable. It was pretty high.
Now, remember, in high school, they don't have the uncatchable. So interference is interference, regardless.
Be called on Bellinger.
Pass interference called against the Warriors.
Huge break for Dow, and that's a back-breaking blow for Bay City Western. I don't think
it's not a first down. Not a first down.
So the chains were kind of hesitated there. The chains were moving, and the referee was making a point it was not. But it's turns a third and 19 into a third and about 3.5. Much more manageable. Receivers all over the field, and Bay City Western jumps early. And that will give them the first down. So they had them third and 19 and two penalties in a row. And it's first and 10 Chargers from the 33.
You want something to happen in a minute and 28 as long as you have the wind.
Yeah. I don't think Dow will be very conservative here. A quick handoff to Cook, and this time a great job by that Warrior defense. Going to probably get back to the line of scrimmage. Bring up second and 10.
Ball carried by number 4, Brendan Cook for the Chargers.
Jet sweep.
Yep. Not your favorite play.
Well, as I say to you, it's the return is not worth the effort. It's not worth the effort of practicing. It's not worth the effort of running. It's just a loser play.
But the
it does stretch the defense
stretch
a little bit.
And Dow does so many different things. Yeah. You just one more thing you got to be worried about. Man, back to pass. Fires downfield. Oh boy, it puts it on the money in. Cook with the drop. That was a well thrown ball. That post pattern. And again, that slick ball. We've seen a few drops tonight, Coach.
We're going to see a lot more. That ball is going to get worse and worse as the night goes on. And like I say, it doesn't matter how much you dry it on the sideline. The field is wet, so every time it touches the field, it gets wet again.
30 seconds remaining in the quarter. You say the significance of that is Dow has the wind at their backs. Third and 10 from the 33. For Dow's offense, it just seems like 10 yards is a manageable distance.
Absolutely.
No matter where they are. Man, it's a quarterback draw. He's not going to get it. Good job by the Warrior defense. Brody Lewis and Grant Fry in on the stop. Ball down to the 30. It'll bring up fourth and 7. Sure, you know, they'll go for it. No
reason
to punt
here.
This
is a pretty good Western defense. I mean, they're not a bad Western defense, but if you notice, they play high, and Dow is able to stay low. And they're trying to pass rush. There's no doubt about that. But they're up a little bit too high for me.
Did not get the snap off. I don't know if man realized the game clock was about to wind down. So they'll flip sides here. And Dow will be going into the win now. And folks, you're watching this Bay City Western HH Dow High homecoming football game on MCTV. Messages on Charter Communications, cable channel 189 in Midland. You can also find MCTV under channel 99 on AT&T's UVerse. The game will be cablecast on the following dates and times. It's Friday, September 30th at 11 p.m., Saturday, October 1st, and Sunday, October 2nd at 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. More dates and times will follow next week on MPS-TV 190. You can check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org. MCT volunteers and staff will also videotape Midland versus Dow swimming, volleyball, and football later in October. And great job by our crew, as always, bringing you these games. And it's a great service to our community as MCTV with all the guys in the booth bringing you the action, the replays, the high quality picture. And we'll get underway here in the second quarter. It's fourth and 7 for Dow High. Stevenson in the backfield. Man barking the signals. Man back to pass. Floats one up and it's off target. He kind of short armed that a little. He tried to guide it a little bit instead of firing it. And pass intended for Stredney, and Bay City Western will take over on downs. First time Charger offense has been denied here tonight.
Well, you can see right now the ball has very little zip on it. It's a floating ball. It's almost like you're throwing a changeup. You know, it's coming off your palm instead of off your fingers.
Mm-hmm. He gets that, the leather gets slick and just can't grip it quite.
Throw it off your palm.
So Coffey, the Charger quarterback, will be a pitch right. Halfback option, receiver's wide open, and he catches it, and he's going to go the distance. What a play call. The defender slipped. It was kind of a hitch and go, and Ryan Miller on the hitch. The Charger defense went down, and the halfback option pass, nobody remotely close to him.
Wow.
That's Liam Tobin with the toss. And as you can see, all by himself, had 15 yards clear. And just like that, Bay City Western strikes, and we have a ball game.
Great play call.
Great play call.
I mean, just caught him, sleep him.
Justin Schaefer with the extra point is up, and it is good. And 15 seconds into the second quarter, Charger lead narrowed to 13-7. Got to admit, I didn't see that coming.
I did not either.
Neither did Dow.
No, nobody did. It was a perfect. The only thing you wondered, will he catch it?
I know, you did.
You wondered, is he going to catch it?
When you have so much time to think about it.
Right.
And it's a wet ball, but Miller did a good job. And the temptation is to start running before you catch it.
Absolutely.
And, but he made sure he had it, and then it was see you later for Miller. So the homecoming crowd here are a little bit stunned right now. Dow have been in complete control of this game.
Well, they came out with the quarterback under center, which is normally their run formation. So the quarterback goes back, throws the ball. The receiver made a good little move out there. The defender slips, and it's a wide open touchdown.
So coming into this game, Miller had one catch for 42 yards. That was a catch for 70. So Miller's yard per reception is pretty impressive.
I'd probably be throwing a little bit more than Miller.
56 yards per catch. A little squib kick. Oh, good job by Dow High return man. Excellent return. It's a Hunter Clipper, number 25. Did a good job. If he doesn't retrieve the ball, anything could happen. And then he just took off and gained about 15 yards.
Again, good field position for Dow.
We'll see how Dow responds here. Just get the feeling this is a veteran team. I don't see them being rattled by that big play from BC Western. Dow High coming off a great year last year, and they are in prime position to make the postseason again. As we mentioned, 5-0 coming in. A win tonight will secure another playoff spot. So Stevenson and Guerrier in the backfield. Guerrier takes the handoff and run down. Good defensive play by Liam Tobin. He's made a couple good plays tonight. Guerrier is going to lose a couple on the carry. Bring up second and 12. I think the rain is stopped, Coach. You had predicted that we were going to get a window with, where the rain was going to stop. And so here it is.
I have weather bug.
Apparently.
On my app, so
you probably update it. Pitch left, Guerrier, and again a big defensive play. And again, it's Liam Tobin. Number 15, Tobin, has made big plays to the left and to the right in consecutive plays. The Chargers moving backwards. It'll be third and 17. Last time they were in a similar spot when it was third and 19. Bay City Western committed two big penalties. See if could be more disciplined here. See what man has up his sleeve. Quarterback position. Back to pass. Over the middle, and a little bit short. Underthrew him a bit. It was probably would have picked up first down. Cook did that quick in right at the sticks. But a little bit underthrown, and Dow will have to punt for the first time tonight. Mann is the punter for Dow High.
This will be interesting because kicking into the wind has been an adventure for Western. Let's see what happens for Dow.
Two men deep.
Good snap.
For Western. High kick. Short and takes a Western bounce. Only going to be about a 18-yard punt or so. There's what you called that. Rain picked up again and that stiff breeze. He kicked it high, but the wind just ate it up. And the ball, Western will take over at the 44-yard line. 32, Michael Recall, senior. A lot of seniors out there for Dow. Finn will check out.
Number
13-7, Dow on top, 10 minutes to go in the first half.
Good
hand
swarming
up,
defense.
And he just got swarmed under with a sea of green. That was Tobin on the carry. Host of Charger defenders on the stop. Here at Johnson, 54 among them. Going to lose a yard. It'll bring up second and 11. Your window of clear skies has
gone.
Is gone already. Back to that steady rain drifting across the field from right to left. Pitch right, Tobin. And he's going to pick up the first, I think. Depends where they mark. No, he's going to go out of bounds at the 49. Pick up about 7 on the play. Make that 6. Boy, he took off. It looked like he had room to run, but he had stepped out of bounds. The Chargers knew it. Bring up a 3rd and 5 for Bay City Western.
We've called Tobin quite a bit tonight.
We have.
You know, he's playing a pretty good ball game this first half.
Charger fans braving the elements. Power eye formation. And
they attempted a reverse, and it's pretty hard to run a reverse inside with minimal amount of blocking.
Yeah, that little trickeration again. This time it didn't work. Dow all over it. Stevenson in on that stop. And so this time Western will punt with the wind at their backs from their own 45. Stredney back deep. Western was waiting for that halfback option until they had the win at their back, don't you think?
Could be.
So
could
I'm not sure that would have worked as well, throwing it into the wind.
Of course, he was so wide open that he could have waited forever like a punt. It was like a punt.
Oh, I might have got a piece of it. I think heavy pressure by Bricall, number 32. I don't know if he got a piece of it or not, but even if he didn't, the pressure caused a punt to sail out of bounds at the 34-yard line. So decent field position for the Chargers. Offense has stalled the last two possessions.
Last two possessions they've
ever
stalled.
Since they started going
exactly.
into the wind, really.
Exactly. It's a nasty wind out there. And not only is it blowing hard, but it's kind of swirling a little bit.
First and 10, Dow. Handful of Bay City Western fans on the opposite side. Some students braving the elements on a nasty night. Bunch formation to the right here. And this one's going to be a little incomplete. So, man, a little short on that pass, too. Try to make it look like it was going to be a little bubble screen out here to the right. Instead, they went to the left, and it'll be incomplete.
You know, I love the way Mann stands in there. There was a lot of pressure coming from a stunt linebacker, and he stood right in there and made the throw, was ready to take the hit. But, again, we're talking about terrible field, terrible weather conditions and ball handling conditions.
Yeah. You have to say it has been a factor here tonight so far. Second and 10. Man back to pass again. Flag on the play. Fires sure. He might have been getting rid of that one.
Flag on the play.
Illegal procedure.
Yeah, I think Man and the receiver were not on the same page on that one. They're going to wouldn't you decline this penalty?
Absolutely.
Bring up 3rd and 10.
Our sideline crew seems to not be with it.
They thought
they were going to take the penalty. Yeah. Why would you take the penalty? No, it's 3rd and 10.
3rd and 10.
Penalty declined, brings up 3rd and 10 for the Chargers.
Trips right for Dow High. Man, back to pass again. Quarterback draw. He's got room to run. He's got the first down and more. Still on his feet. Man around the left side into Western territory all the way inside the 35-yard line. So, man showing that elusiveness, showing some decent speed. Bounces great. It outside. First down now.
Great call. Quarterback draw. Spread the team out. Run through the open slot. Good job of blocking up front by the Dow front, and good job of blocking downfield. And now that we see receivers out there and man doing what he does best.
Big play for Dow just when they needed it. He had been sputtering, and now they're moving. Manned pass, short again. I think he caught this one. Cook on the play. Gonna pick up about seven. Down to the 26-yard line. 13-7, Dow in front, 7.5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Nasty night here at Midland Community Stadium. Good number of Dow faithful here cheering on their team, though. Man, a little option to Stevenson to the right. Sheds a tackler, oh, but then he loses his footing. Pretty good play there by Brendan Bellinger. Thought that initial hit, Stevenson was gonna be able to keep going, but he tripped him up just enough. So the option is, he's gonna, may lose a yard. Bring up third and seven.
Tripped up by number 41, Brendan Bellinger.
Another wrinkle for Dow. Sometimes I think they just throw some of those plays in there just so you got to have it in your mind. It could happen.
You got to practice them. Again, he's so far left. So far left that it'd be hard to.
Stevenson, the carrier, driving ahead. He's got the first down and a little bit more inside the 20. Good play call. Got good blocking and then that power running by Spencer Stevenson.
I like that play better than the option. That puts Stevenson going straight ahead where he's at his best, not running laterally. He has good speed, but not great speed.
But he has great power.
He has great power.
First and 10 from the 18. Dow High on the move, up by 6. Trying to make it more. This time it's Nick Siraki in the backfield. Goes in motion left. Man, back to pass. There's that slant again. Got him. Touchdown. Beautifully thrown ball.
Perfect pass.
By Mann. He scored three times on that little post pattern or a slant.
They moved the safety out of there with motion and then right now came right back and threw the post.
Cook with his third touchdown pass. Mann with a third touchdown pass. Extra point attempt for the Chargers. This time a better snap and hold. And the kick is good. So with 6:01 remaining in the second quarter, Dow High responds offensively, go up 20-7. We were talking for the game coach is Jason Watkins. Man is kind of the fourth in a line of some pretty good quarterbacks that have come through the Dow High system under Coach Watkins. Go back to Brendan Sklenar, when Dow really kind of took a big leap forward as a program. Sklenar went on to play quarterback at Denison down in Ohio. Brendan Miller, pretty fair quarterback as well. And then Alec Marty, most recently before Mann, was an outstanding quarterback as well as basketball player for Dow.
You know, one thing you want to point out, this Bay City Western team, well, Mann was their quarterback freshman sophomore year, and he's a transfer from Western. So they have a lot to prove right here.
And the ball is loose. And
Joe Fabiano.
So the initial Western player didn't field it, and by the time he did, he just got popped. And Joe Fabiano alertly picks it up and races down the sideline. And Dow High is knocking on the door once again. Well-conceived special teams play on that kickoff. Kicker put it right into kind of no man's land there. Western did not handle the kick return very well.
This is usually
great special teams play.
This is usually where Dow goes right for
the jugular
for the big play. Yeah.
Caden Skinner, another 6'2" receiver, comes in. He's a tight end, number 85. We're going to see that post again. Oh, this time it's going to be a handoff, and driving ahead is Siraki. Nick Siraki, just a sophomore. He's going to pick up about 8. Boy, sure expected a pass on that play.
I sure
think Western did too. But good blocking up front.
That's the same play that Stevenson ran about 2 or 3 plays ago.
You can see the rain in that previous shot, and it has picked up. Dow High trying to really put a hurt on Western here. Stevenson in motion. It's going to be the slant again. Then he tries to take it outside. Kind of a little, tried to take it in then out. Intended for Stredney. Incomplete. Bring up a 3rd and 3 for Dow.
That was very good defense on the part of Western. You know, I don't understand Bay City. Like last week, Bay City Central had yellow numbers.
Yeah, I was.
And Bay City Western has yellow numbers. It's hard to see their numbers.
I was just thinking that very thing.
It's hard to
try
to game.
Give credit to the defender out there.
Right.
But you just can't read the numbers.
And Bay City Central's only has a half color.
Yeah, right. That's right. It's half purple, half yellow. Guerrier on the handoff, but a great defensive play by Bay City Western. That was number 21, Ross Patterson. Going to lose yardage. It'll bring up a 4th and 5. You almost have to go for it. It's really tough kicking conditions.
Right, you're gonna go for it.
Even if they don't get it, Bay City Western's going to have it deep in their own territory. Going with that 4-receiver bunch formation out to the left. You see that quarterback draw again? He's looking for his receiver. There got to be a flag.
Flag on the play.
Tried again on that slant intended for Stredney. And clearly it was contact before the ball arrived. Again, it's what you talked about. They split 4 to the left and just kind of removed 2/3 of the defense, really. Just really turning it into a 2-man play. I think Western contending it was incidental contact, but
that was incidental.
It was a pretty easy call.
Yeah. When two officials call it, they pretty well bet that that's the call.
It will be 1st down, Dow. So 2nd time Dow has gotten a 1st down on a penalty.
You have 7 officials out there. It's pretty hard to get away with anything.
That's true. Ball caught the 6. Man, back to pass, fakes a reverse. Man, fires for the corner, and it is dropped. I don't know if he'd have been inbounds anyway. I think the receiver, Cook, was really trying to think of keep his feet inbounds while he was trying to catch it. Pretty good pass by Man.
Very good pass for that.
Into the wind, really tight spiral.
Into the wind, into the corner. Again, trying to take advantage of your 6'4" guy on their guy.
Couldn't. No chance of an interception. Going with that 4 receivers out to the left. Again, not quite bunched as much. Man, a little bubble screen to Stevenson, and he's going to drive in for the touchdown. Every time they had 4 out there, I was expecting that play,
exactly.
And this time they ran it.
Exactly.
Caught Stevenson with a head of steam, and he's just going to be really hard to bring down in that situation.
And a good receiver.
Yeah.
For a big guy, he's a good receiver.
With a wet ball.
And, you know, there's an example there of a turnover that, you know, the ball game could have been turned around on the long touchdown pass mm-hmm. by Western. Dow came right back, scores, and then gets the turnover. And now it's 26-7, 27-7, and pretty much out of reach now. I mean, and now it's only, there's still 4 minutes to go in the second quarter, but I've got to say, this game is out of reach.
It's going to be really tough, especially in these conditions, to, you know, Western is going to have to put it up in the air, you figure, in the second half, and it's just going to be hard to do. 27-7, 4:12 to go in the second quarter. Dow High in command. This is really, if you want to be truthful, really one play for Western offensively, that 70-yard halfback option. Haven't been able to do much else. And Dow's offense has just racked up the yardage, spreading the wealth.
I'm impressed with Mann in that even though he doesn't have zip, he still has lots of touch.
Yeah.
You know, the touch is there. That was a touch pass.
Well, retrieved at the 15. That's Tobin. Really running east to west on there. It's going to be tough to get very far. Good defensive or special teams play by Aaron Reardon, number 51. First down, Bay City Western. You figure you got to make something happen with the wind at your back here. 4 minutes to go in the half to really stay in it. Need to mount an attack here and try to trim that Dow High lead. Three receivers to the right. Myers in motion. He'll end up on the right side. And tried a little quick slant intended for Alicio Vasquez Landon. Just tried a little curl there, but off the mark was Coffee, third and 10. And here's a dangerous thing. They tried to move it down, but, if you go three and out, Dow's going to get the ball in good field position.
That's exactly right.
And get another shot at the score. 10, Parker Rivard, very tall receiver for Western, split out wide to the left. Coffee back to pass. Over the middle, got his man, that's Tobin. Going to get a first down. Well thrown ball by Coffee that time, and Tobin has been all over the field for Western.
So you have to recognize, Western's receivers are so far away from their quarterback that the quarterback can't reach him out here. So you know the ball's going to go to the center of the field. It's not going to go out here. You really just have to cover space.
Yeah.
You don't have to cover a man. You just have to cover a space. If he's going to be foolish enough to throw it over here, you're going
to
intercept it.
Yeah.
See, the rule is if I'm no further away than the hash, so this guy that's on the line here on the numbers is never going to get the ball because the quarterback can't throw it that far.
Oh, off to the races. There goes it. It might be Tobin again. Hauled down. And it's going to be a flag. I think that's an easy call, too. He's out of bounds, and he got thrown down. Liam Tobin again with a big play. Boy, just a quick burst. And I think Dow playing pass defense all the way there. But Tobin bursts up the middle off to the right side. And you're going to march it off. They're running the clock, but I think he might be. I think what happened is the clock was. I don't know what happened. He was trying to get the clock down to a certain time. Despite that going out of bounds and the penalty, he was running it, but now it stopped. They moved the chains. First and 10, Western at the 12-yard line. And that's a direct snap to Grant Fry. Big running back. Tried the power game there, but Dow sniffs that one out. And he's going to lose a yard. Clock winds, 3:10 to go in the second quarter. Western desperately trying to put some points on the board.
It's exactly the way to go, though. That's a good play for them. It's just that Dow overpowered the offensive line. Come on,
guys, good play. 71 Lance Johnson, 5'11", 225. Doing a good job. And nothing doing that time either. That's Garrett Johnson, 54 on the stop. Same thing, coach. Overpowered.
They pulled a guard, and when they pulled the guard got stuffed in the backfield. The running back ran into the guard, who got stuffed by the offensive tackle. And again, they're losing yards.
Third and so call it 11.
They'll throw the ball here.
They almost have to. I think they're trying to use a little clock. We're 2 minutes to go.
Same play that one.
Still got a
little
score.
Bit over the middle.
Coffey rolls right, throws left to Tobin. He catches it. It's going to be short of the first down. And then he's brought down by that's Michael Burkault.
Bring good defense on Dow's part. Tobin slipped out of the backfield. That was a good call by the Bay City Western coaches. Now the question is, can they get a 4th and 8, 6?
Dow was going to call timeout, 4th and 6, and that the rain is really coming down now. Winds are howling. You can watch this Bay City Western HH Dow High homecoming football game on. Well, if nothing else, one thing Western achieved was kill some clock here in the half.
Kill some clock. Field position. Changed the tilted the field a little bit. Things can happen here on 4th down. Even if they don't get the first down, Dow stuck in the backside of it. There's 1:31 left, so this would be a big touchdown for Western if they could get it.
Well, you go into the locker room with some confidence. You're down by 2 touchdowns instead of 3.
This is a good timeout by Dow.
I agree.
Good timeout. Just
settle,
kind of get set. Let Western, it's like icing it. You know, you kind of ice the other team a little bit. And let the other coach out-coach himself. That was always my thought. You're not going to come up with the play you really wanted to call. You're going to come up with something maybe a little more exotic, which is in my favor. That was a very good timeout. I'm not a big fan of timeouts, but that was a good timeout. One that was needed.
So,
find Tobin.
In 6.
Find Tobin.
Definitely. Coffey rolls right. Tobin in the backfield to block. He's found his man. Touchdown. Nice job by the Warriors. Really well
good
run
play. Good play.
Delicio Vasquez Landon for the Western touchdown. Very impressive drive by Bay City Western.
Very good.
That's just a good play. They cleared out the backfield. With two receivers going in, Vasquez slips out to the right. So it's just him. And once he beat his defender, it's easy touchdown. Extra point attempt is low, and it is still good. Shot through by Justin Schaefer. And with 1:27 to go in the half, this Bay City Western team's got some fight, coach.
Well, see, here's the thing. When you get 4th down, the one thing you tell your outside guys is you must contain the quarterback. He cannot get out on the perimeter. He must have pressure coming from outside in. Dow rushed up the middle. They didn't have a shot at the guy. He rolls around to the right, makes a perfect strike into the receiver, and without any pressure, the receiver catches the ball, runs in the end zone. So it was a beautiful play by Western. And really, Dow could have done much better on that corner.
It's Vasquez Landon's 3rd touchdown reception on the year. He's their leading receiver, coming in with 19 catches for 132 yards.
Yeah, we haven't heard his name tonight.
No. So, into the wind. 2-touchdown game once again. Squib kick. Ball's loose and alertly fallen on. It's a smart play. So they're trying to pick up a wet ball in a wet field. It's covered up by Bricault, I believe. Or no, that might have been Brendan Doyle, 22.
Now, here's an interesting dilemma. Do you run the clock out or do you go for it? Now, if you go for it and they get the ball back and score again, now all the momentum shift is really in their favor. You'd get a 27-21 game. Whereas maybe you're a little cautious here.
Well, man, back to pass, so. Not cautious. He's going for it all, and it's almost, should have been picked off.
And should have been caught.
Oh, my. Bellinger had the interception.
That's exactly what I was talking about. The ball was going to be intercepted by a free safety sitting in the middle of the field, and didn't happen.
And then it goes right to Cook, and you just don't really expect that to happen. Drops it, and the conditions keep getting tougher here to throw the ball. It's going to be a quarterback draw this time. You can see that coming. Man is corralled. Picked up some decent yardage. Dow High is going to call timeout. Man brought down by Grant Fry after a 5-yard pickup. Coach Watkins immediately calls timeout with 1:08 to go. Probably figuring if we can get the first down here, then we try to do something with it.
Well, Dow's always in a 2-minute offense, so, you know, it's...
Sure we're not bashful on that first down play.
No, they weren't.
It's actually three times Western today could have had an interception and dropped it.
Remember what I said earlier, just set back in your zone, let them throw the ball, they'll drop it, there'll be overthrows, there'll be underthrows, except that they're going to catch some of them. This is the pass defense for this weather.
The rain just keeps getting heavier as we go here. And stiff breeze.
There's a little bit more spring in the step of Bay City Western defense.
Understandably. Man back to pass. Fires. Got his man. It's going to be a first down. And Stredney, one of his favorite targets tonight, 6'3", 170, is going to get the first. Gets alertly out of bounds to stop the clock with 1:02. Ball at the 46. Dow High looking for more. Up by 2 touchdowns. Well, they're going to run the clock here. Guess he didn't get out of bounds. Stevenson in motion left. Man, back to pass. It's going to be a screen, inside screen to Cook, and nothing doing. Dow likes that play and has had some success with it, but sniffed out nicely by Bay City Western that time. It was Tyler Sionek on the stop.
And again, it was a changeup, not a fastball.
Yeah.
Ball floated out there.
Dow will call another timeout here. Their last of the half. But it's, yeah, the ball has got to be pretty heavy right now, Coach, with the heavy rain, stiff breeze. Hard to put some zip on that ball. Just didn't have as many blockers around as usual on
usually
that screen.
Usually what you see, right? Well, I think they were there, but they were downfield a little more than they should have been because the play took so long to happen. It's really a true. Screens are all about timing.
Second and 10 for Dow. A little tight formation this time. Man back to pass over the middle again. Incomplete.
Here comes
another
flag.
Flag on the play. Third pass interference call on Western tonight. Caden Skinner, the intended receiver.
See, again, basically Western's playing man. If they're playing zone, they're sitting back there. And now you just catch this ball. You just sit in the zone and catch it.
James will move down to the 39-yard line, 44 seconds to go in the half. Dow certainly not bashful, despite the conditions. Trying to put some more points on the board. Man back to pass. Quick out, Cook drops it. That time he tried to run before he caught it, I think. Well thrown ball, that one had a little more zip on it. Kind of a quick out, and then he tried to catch and make a quick move
right in, but
made the move before he corralled the ball.
And what do you tell your receivers in a two-minute drill? Get out of bounds.
Yeah.
So you catch the ball,
get out of bounds.
Instead
of in.
Right. You don't have to score a touchdown.
And they don't have any timeouts left.
Stop the clock. Stop the clock. Get the first down. We'll go for another play.
Second and 10 from the 39. 40 seconds to go. 40.6 to be precise. Empty backfield. Man under pressure. Got his man. And he's going to be stay in bounds. It's going to take a lot of time on this play. It's caught by Bricault, 32. Clock is running. Third and six for Dow. 16, 15. Man, back to pass. Looks it up, out of bounds. It'll bring up fourth down with 11 seconds to go. That ball sailed on him that time. Man's percentage not quite as high as normal, but understandably, there's been a couple of drops. And ball has sailed on him a couple times. So fourth down, 11 seconds to go. They get the first.
Here comes
don't get out of bounds.
I'm looking at a hook and ladder.
All right. Ziraki in motion. Man, under pressure. He's brought down. He fumbles the ball. Still alive. It's not going to matter because it was a fourth down play. Heavy pressure by Bay City Western. And Dow will turn it over on downs. Man, took a hit with 3.4 to go. See the ball loose there, but Dow High recovered. That was Cesar Gonzalez. But Bay City Western, they might go for it here, I guess, but. Bay City Western's gonna call timeout to discuss their options. What do you think here, Coach?
Well, my thinking is I'm gonna take a knee, but when you're in this situation, many times you say, well, what have I got to lose? I'm gonna shoot it. Well, what you got to lose is the ball gets intercepted and run back for a touchdown. So you just say to yourself, all right, we're 27-16, two touchdowns is not insurmountable. Our defense is playing really fairly good, and Dow's offense is not playing very well, even though it has 27 points.
You can see the shot of Coach Watkins talking to his defense and the rain, which just seems like it gets heavier by the minute here. We have the homecoming festivities with the homecoming court will take place. Just won't have the marching band tonight.
Now, I wouldn't come up within 10 or 15 yards of the line of scrimmage because they're going to do something. There's the run.
Handoff. All right. It's going to be Liam Tobin, who had a phenomenal first half. Going to pick up about 16 on that as the clock runs out on the first half. Pretty entertaining half.
Very entertaining.
It looked like Dow was just going to steamroll over this game, but give Bay City Western credit. A big half Back option pass, scored one, and then a nice drive at the end of the half. And we go into the locker room at 27-14 with the Dow High on top.
Well, Dave, I got to tell you, I really think Bay City Western has played a great half. Dallas played a very uninspired half, and that's comes there. But, you know, you really take a look at the weather as a factor, and the underdog always has an advantage in this kind of weather. So we'll see what happens second half.
Dallas racked up some yardage, that's for sure. They're not quite as clean of a half as they're used to. Officials are, they're saying let's run the clock, 15 minutes of halftime in front of us. These teams clear the field, and we are going to send it down to the field for today's homecoming festivities, and we'll be back with more action in the second half.
The 2016 Dow High Charger Homecoming Court. Walking onto the field are the freshman class representatives and their parents from the class of 2020. Anna Jensen, daughter of Craig and Lara Jensen. Xander Brooks, son of Malcolm and April Brooks. Nikki Melikar, daughter of Paul and Beth Melikar. Beth will be represented by Kim Alders, Nikki's grandmother, godmother. Nate Nichols, son of Pete and Joanna Nichols. Congratulations to the freshman class representatives and their families. Now, representing the class of 2019, Jocelyn Brubaker, daughter of Timothy Brubaker and Sarah Prill. Adam Elfewall, son of Tammy Elfewall. Ashley Ahrens, daughter of Jay and Sarah Ahrens. Davis Pertell, son of Joe and Gigi Pertell. Congratulations to the sophomore class representatives and their families. Next on the field are the class of 2018 representatives. Please welcome Haley Snyder, daughter of Mike and Kathy Snyder. Jacob Passick, son of Dave and Angela Passick. Madison Soul, daughter of Al and Tammy Soul. And John Redding, son of Jeffrey and Sheila Redding. Congratulations to the junior class representatives and their families. The Dow High King and Queen will be selected from the following senior class representatives. Liz Wegner is the daughter of Michael and Laura Bambley. Liz is hoping to study fashion merchandising and design at Central Michigan University. She is a member of the POMP team, drama club, and thespian society, and student leadership. She also works at Vanity in the mall. Liz Wegner. Ben Price is the son of Sam and Sue Price. Ben hopes to go to the University of Notre Dame or the University of Chicago to study psychology and law. He is the senior drum major in the marching band, percussionist in the symphonic band, jazz band, and the symphonic orchestra,
He is also the president of the International Thespian Society, Ben Price. Joanna Danielson is the daughter of Peter and Amy Danielson. Joanna would like to study international studies and or political science. She is the Dow Palm Captain, Key Club President, Co-President of Youth Empowerment Initiative, and also involved in DECA, Chemistry Club, and is the Trinity Lutheran Church Assistant Youth Director. Joanna Danielson. David Brandon is the son of Rich and Beth Brandon. David plans to study mechanical engineering or science and then plans to attend dental school. He is currently undecided on which university he will attend. David is in marching and symphonic bands. The robotics team 2619, the Charge, plays varsity baseball, is in the National Honor Society, and is an Eagle Scout. He is also in his church youth group. David Brandon. Nadia Aton is the daughter of Scott and Laura Aton. She will be attending Northwood University to study accounting and play on the Northwood volleyball team. Nadia is involved in volleyball, basketball, DECA, and DECA for Dow High. Nadia Aton. Arhan Servastava is the son of Shivani Bala. Arhunt is applying to colleges to become a mechanical engineer. He is the executive state officer for the Michigan Business Professionals of America, is a member of Big Brothers Big Sisters, and loves to sing, play guitar, and make his own music. Arhunt Servastava. Ladies and gentlemen, our class of 2017 senior class homecoming representatives. Last year's homecoming queen, Ms. Brinley Leonhardt, is unable to be with us this evening and sends her congratulations to the homecoming court this evening from Brigham Young University. Our Dow High School assistant principal, Mrs. Carla Cook, will crown our Dow High School queen. Last year's homecoming king, Mr. Luke Drumright, is here tonight from Saginaw Valley State University to present the medallion to our king. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dow High School class of 2017 homecoming king is, drum roll please, Ben Price. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dow High School class of 2017 homecoming queen is, drumroll please, Nadia Aton.
The bouquet of yellow roses are being presented to the HH Dow High School homecoming queen on behalf of the Dow High School student body and staff by the Dow High Assistant Principal, Mrs. Jenny Coppins. Dr. Steve Poole, principal of Dow High School, is presenting the Charger Bolt to our homecoming king. Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you this year's Dow High School homecoming court. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as the court leaves the field, please stand for the Charger fight song. The Dow High Charger marching pep band.
We'll be right back.
halftime festivities. Congratulations to the entire homecoming court for Dow High, but in particular, homecoming king Ben Price and the 2016 homecoming queen Nadia Atten. And this is Dave Marsh, along with Frank Altimore, bringing you the action. Action-packed first half for sure, and we're going to be hopefully looking for more of the same here in the second half. And a lot of back and forth, Coach. And you said going into the break, kind of looked like Dow may just run away with this thing, but Bay City Western, to their credit, has fought back and made a game of it.
Well, we made a very entertaining first half. You know, Bay City Western obviously out of the game 27-7, and then all of a sudden comes right back, scores a touchdown, make it 27-14. And as I said, it was a very entertaining first half. But we're going to look at some highlights coming up here. And these will be the touchdowns. Here's the first one. A great pass right there. Nice soft touch. But we saw that all the first half. It was a smooth touch all the way through. There's the first one. There's the second touchdown by man to
Stredney.
And then this is the pitch pass. And somebody fell asleep, and which happens sometimes, and wide open for the touchdown.
Yeah, Liam Tobin throwing the touchdown pass had a big half for Bay City Western. And that was Rand Miller on the reception.
Again, there's a nice soft touch pass. Those are the kind of passes that are really perfectly thrown, tough to stop. That was the swing pass to Spencer Stevenson, and again on the way. And then this is really a good play right here. The linebacker had him in the beginning and then lost him.
And so with that, we are stand at 27-14. And Coach, going into the game, talked about some of the keys for each team, and let's see how they measured up here in the first half.
Well, first off, Dow attacked the secondary, which is what they did. The problem that what happened was that so many of the passes were either dropped or just slightly under or overthrown. So that point is still good. The defensive line play, Dow's defensive line did a great job. And the turnover, the big turnover, was the kickoff that was fumbled and brought down. So keep forcing these turnovers, make them happen. Bay City hasn't made a fumble in their run game, nor have they thrown an interception. So Dow's going to have to work on that. For the Warriors, slow the game down. And this now becomes more important. Take your time. Get the touchdown if you're going to put – and they have put tremendous pressure on man. He stood in there strong, but they've put pressure. And Bay City has, for the most part, taken good care of field position, except their inability to punt into the wind. And that gave Dow their points in the first half. So it'll be interesting to see what happens as the second half rolls on with this.
Well, when you said about the force of turnovers, the turnovers the difference in the game rate.
Exactly.
I mean, Dow has scored, and they get the ball again.
Well, it's a 14-point turnaround.
Right. So, obviously, that was a key play. And Western had some chances to create turnovers of their own. It's kind of the defenders miss some opportunities. But, you know, if you're just not quite ready when that ball is slick. And the ball went through their hands a couple times. And so you can see basically Western doing their halftime stretches. Dow High just coming out of the locker room now to start the second half. I mentioned before, Dow trying to improve to 6-0 on the year, clinch that playoff spot. And the heavy rain continues. You can see it on the screen there.
Well, the other thing we want to remember is that Bay City Western is on a two-game win streak. So, you know, they're getting they lost their first three games and did not look good in their first three games. In the last two games, even though their opponents have not had winning records, they've won the football game. So they have a little taste of winning. And they're really in this game.
Yeah, and you can see it there. The how the rain's coming down, you just never quite sure how that's going to impact things. I was going to give a little shout out to Rich Jude was in the booth for the game, chatting with us, and congratulations to him on being named the new baseball coach at Dow High. Of course, Rich, a kind of a legend for the Chargers, a phenomenal athlete while he was here at Dow, went on to have a great career at Michigan State, and a lot of the Charger faithful, happy to see him back in the fold as the baseball coach.
Now, what a lot of people don't know is Rich's father, Steve, was recently named to the MSU Hall of Fame, Athletic Hall of Fame, which is a tremendous achievement. Steve was a teammate of mine at Michigan State and was just a great quarterback and a great leader.
Quarterback back in the 60s, he was high up in the voting in the Heisman Trophy.
Yeah, he was fourth.
So
fourth
the recent
Heisman.
Past.
Recent past, thank you.
yeah, the great Spartan teams from back then. Was the quarterback, and so yeah, the Jude boys were really terrific athletes here at Dow. And
well, we have a second generation Jude, freshman quarterback Shane Jude.
Yep, Shane, I think when we're broadcasting future games up in the booth, we may be saying his name a time or two on, I'm guessing. He's a freshman at Dow, as you mentioned. Chargers getting loosened up. They put a little more time on the clock. So it's about 2:47 before the kickoff here. Bay City Western will receive in the second half. Call Dow got the kickoff and marched immediately down the field and scored. And so Bay City Western will be trying to do more of the same. Get some of the Chargers as the statistically as they come into this game. Well, we mentioned Dow High, very balanced attack offensively. Second in the Saginaw Valley League Blue Division in total yardage, but first in points scored and first in defense, allowing only 34 points a game. Not have held opponents to under 900 yards so far in the year through five games, 852 coming in. Bay City Western with a couple of long drives will push that total a little bit higher. Mentioned Maurice Guerrier was the leading rusher for Dow coming into the game.
Very quiet tonight.
Man, the second leading rusher. I'm sure he's the leading rusher tonight. A couple of those quarterback draws picking up big yardage. Spencer Stevenson. 56 yards coming in, three touchdowns, and used a little bit. He did score on a touchdown reception. Man with four TD passes tonight to four different teammates. And Zeitler has a couple of rushing touchdowns for Dow coming in. And receivers, Brandon Cook with the 234 yards receiving coming in. He's added a, scored his third touchdown on the year, as did Austin Stredney. Jeremy Contardi, seven catches, 110 yards. Stevenson with his second TD reception on the year. And Joe Fabiano with his third touchdown on the season. About to get underway here. Now we'll kick off. Bay City Western's had some trouble on the kick returns here. Let's see what Dow High looks to do. If they try one of those little pooch, short pooch kicks, kicking with the wind.
It's a little good deeper, kick
caught
inside
at the
20.
13. And hauled down. Nice coverage
good
by
coverage.
Dow once again. That's Matt Chorvath, number 80.
I say this each of our telecasts. This is the most important drive of the game right here. What happens by each team in their possession at the beginning of the second half kind of sets the tone for what the game's all about. Bay City Western has to go out and get a touchdown. They have to bring this game a little bit closer to them. And they can't be in a hurry to do it.
Both their touchdowns with the wind in that second quarter. A little pitch. Trying to find a seam, but a good pursuit by Dow. Pietro Finn on the stop. Stevenson among the Charger tacklers. Do a flag on the play. Preliminary indication is holding against Bay City Western. Probably will send them back here. It's going to be tough for them to gain a lot of yardage. That's and it'll improve field position.
Unless you have a negative play, send them back. This will be second and 20.
Actually, spot foul is going to be second and 22 of all the way back to the 15, holding Curring in the backfield. Yeah, that's really not how Bay City Western wanted to start this half, digging themselves a big hole.
Okay, first and 22. Will Bay City Western go to the pass?
Very good tackle. And Stevenson just meets the ball carrier after about a 1-yard gain.
That was a very good green surge.
Liam Tobin, the carrier. Called Liam Tobin's name a lot tonight. 187 yards rushing coming into the game.
Spencer Stevenson's done a marvelous job tonight on their inside run game.
Tremendous ball player is Stevenson. Second and 21. Coffey back to pass. And it's picked off. You can see that one coming. And Austin Stredney takes it in for the score. Just kind of floated that pass into the flat, and that just spells trouble.
Again, the turnover. The turnover inside your 20-yard line. You just can't do that. You must play field position.
We threw it behind him for one, kind of floated it, and Stredney jumps the pattern.
Beautiful.
Not make the mistake. And a devastating blow struck by Dow. Brooks with the extra point is good.
I have not liked the blocking on our extra point. And they're in there way too much.
Yeah, it's close shot every time.
Every time. They're coming hard off the corner and
Burke's done a pretty good job on those.
Yes, he has.
Points.
Yes, he has.
The first one is really.
The first two were really not his fault. I mean, he got one down.
Yeah, somehow.
Yeah, he got it down and he kicked it through in a crowd.
34-14. And Dow will line up and kick it again. This time with a 3-touchdown lead. That's a devastating blow for Bay City Western.
And now they have to go back on offense again after that.
And
you want to see what's going to, right, you're trying to slow this game down to an absolute crawl.
Kick again, field around the 11. Stuck hard by Jake Bovey.
Now, I am really impressed with Dow's coverage, and I'm watching him come down the field very nicely spaced out. Remember we talked about this last week with Bay City Central. They had very poor spacing. Dow has wonderful spacing that squeezes to the ball. Good football teams do that.
Yeah. Brennan Doyle, a sophomore, also in on that stop. First and 10 from the 27. And that's blown up by Alex Tomiko, number 78. Met the ball carrier in the backfield.
Well, this has been Bay City's big problem in that their linemen, they do not sustain their blocks. So Dow is getting off the block and into the backfield, creating a new line of scrimmage about 2 yards deep in the backfield. Bay City Central is, or Bay City Western just is not getting off the ball and into the blocking of the defensive line. And Dow's defensive line is just whipping them.
Second and 12. Start has half been a struggle for Western. It's the pitch and great pursuit once again. That's Stevenson again on the stop. 2 yard pickup. Kind of a odd quick pitch to Tobin. A little harm done. It'll bring up a third and 10. Kevin Murray now in on the defensive
line.
The
question is, what do you do here? Because any throw that you make in this area is a touchdown for the other team if you're not careful.
I was going to say, you got to go over the middle. You pass it. And it's not a pass. It's off tackle and just nowhere to run.
Again, Dow's defensive line is in the backfield.
Garrett Johnson met the ball carrier and just blown up. Go back 2 more yards.
That intercepted pass was a crushing blow to Western. Now, Dow is going to get the football probably somewhere around the 40-yard line of Western.
Kicking into that wind we've been talking about all night. Stradney back deep to receive. A little better punt. Stradney catches it on the fly. Hauled down immediately, but good job catching it. Saves some yardage.
Much better punt.
Mitch Myers on the stop. Much better punt. Kind of expected Dow to have it in Bay City territory. Instead, they'll start from their own 47. Still a very good field position. 7:57 to go in the third quarter. Dow up 34-14. Dow scored on 4 touchdown passes and an interception return for a touchdown tonight. Guerrier, lone setback, takes the pitch right. The ball's on the ground, and Bay City Western recovers. Might have taken his eye off of that pitch, trying to survey the field. And Tobin with the fumble recovery.
Who else?
Wow. Regardless of the outcome of this game, Liam Tobin has played
MVP.
Whale of a game.
He's MVP right now, in my mind.
So Bay City Western, a huge break. First time that Dow really took snap under center all night. Figure that might be a little safer. It results in a fumble. Bay City Western, great field position. The Dow 43. Trips right. Coffee back to pass. Fires over the middle. Sails over the head of the intended receiver, Mitch Myers. Bring up a second and 10. A lot of traffic in the center of the field there.
Here's an example. Okay, get the ball in this position right here. So you've watched a lot of television. So what do you say? Well, let's just go for it. Okay, no. Get down the field. You know, think a little bit. When your quarterback is not a good thrower and your receivers are just average, run the football. Get down the field. You're in 4-down territory. And now it's 3-down territory. Now there's movement. And now it's 2nd and 15.
Second and 15.
See, this is what I mean. There's too much Madden football going on, in my mind. You know, there's not strategy. that should be employed. In this case, we got lousy weather.
It is
boring. And so run the football, take your four downs, get back into the ball game, make it a two-touchdown game. Make it a two-touchdown game. Don't make it a four-touchdown the other way game. And that's what they're going to do right now. They're going to throw the ball again.
Coffee rolls.
And it's going to be a penalty.
Flag. It's going to be.
And now it's second,
second and 20.
This is what I'm saying. You know, you can't do something that you're incapable of doing. So don't do that. Do what you're capable of doing. Granted, they've had some troubles running the football. But, you know, sometimes you just got to get up there and have your offensive line do the job for you.
It is flat out pouring right now at the stadium.
Oh, Dave, I'm so glad I'm in here on the press box.
I'm perfect in here.
I've got to tell you right now.
They're going to call offsides on Dow on that play. It'll break for Western.
Yeah.
Big difference between second and 10 and second and 20, that's for sure. You feel you can manage second and 10. The second 20 was going to be mighty tough. Trips right for Western. Tobin lone setback. Quick out and incomplete. Coffee misfires, looking for Parker Rivard. Bring up third and 10. That's a pretty good play call. You get just pretty safe play. You just
very safe.
Just misfired.
Right.
That was one where they're going to try to pick up about half the yardage on the first play.
Again, and it's hard to fault any quarterback throwing the ball tonight.
Yeah. Oh,
the,
yeah.
The ball is shot, and it's very hard to grip.
He's going deep this time, and it is incomplete. Ball sailed on him. Bring up fourth and 10. So the turnover. Western, they might go for it here.
Oh, they're definitely going to go for it.
You almost have to, don't you?
I mean, you're down. You're down three touchdowns.
Probably not going to gain a lot of the punt anyway.
But again, that pass there was probably 20 yards too far for the quarterback to throw it accurately.
Fourth and 10.
Where is Tobin?
Exactly.
That's exactly what you're looking for. He's going to get the ball.
Stays blocked over the middle, incomplete. A little contact there. He got the, and they do call the flag.
Oh, that's an awful call.
I'm not surprised. Western's been flagged for that call a couple times tonight. Pretty late flag. Looked like there was a little contact. It is going to be a first down for a Western. Ball will go all the way to the 28-yard line. Pass interference to call. 7.5 to go in the third. Western with huge break.
It's hard to make a call like that when you have feet get tangled up with each other. You know, it's one thing to have your hands on them.
First 10, Western. It's a direct snap. He's just met at the line of scrimmage by Connor Moe, number 44. It's a direct snap to Western's number 44, Grant Fry. So no gain on the play, second and 10. Play hasn't tried that a couple times tonight, has not produced much. Just under 7 minutes to go in the half, or in the quarter, excuse me. Western trying to stay in this game. There's that pitch left to Tobin. Cuts up the field, and he's got the first down. Nicely done by Tobin. He Look, he might pop outside, but cutting back up is going to get him the yardage necessary for the first.
That was nicely designed. They had a lead back on the corner, and Tobin did make the turn. Tobin's given him a lot of yards tonight.
He has. And on that long touchdown, he doesn't get the yardage, but he threw the pass. Clock runs, 6:30 to go in the third quarter. Western on the move, trying to cash in on the Dow High fumble. Ball at the 17. Quick out of the backfield. Good catch by Tobin. He's met and driven out of bounds, but he's going to pick up about 6 or 7. Pretty nifty play there.
That's the same play that they scored the touchdown on.
Running back slips out of the backfield. It was Tobin, and he kind of cleared out that side of the field. We'll give him 5 on the play. Second and 5. Weston chewing up some clock here on this drive. Big Jacob Vantola, right tackle. Coffee back to pass. Throws the slant, and it's touchdown, Bay City Western. That goes to Grant Fry, number 44. Nicely thrown ball.
Very nice. Very nice play.
Similar play that Dow has scored a couple times on.
Now, kind of interesting. A couple weeks ago, Bay City Western played Midland right here. And going into the fourth quarter, the score was 25-19. Now, Midland got 2 touchdowns in the fourth quarter to kind of put the game away. But Bay City Western is coming back. That was an excellent drive, aided by the pass interference.
Yeah, huge call in the pass interference. Extra point is up, and it is good. Put through the uprights by Mitch Myers, and just like that, 34-21. Boy, we sure are tempted to write off Bay City Western.
We keep writing them off, and again, now it's a very manageable 2-touchdown deficit. Very manageable.
It's the kind of hanging around, and it's the kind of game where, you know, you could see some turnovers happening, and that's obviously the game changes on it. Both teams converting on turnovers here to start the half. Western will kick off from their 40, take another look at the pass. Right on the money. Not bad coverage, you just got a half a step on him, and Coffee led him and got his second TD pass of the game. Another squib kick at the 21. Good coverage that time by Bay City Western. Jared Goslin on the stop along with John Owens. After Bricault had
good ball protection.
Picked up the ball, yeah.
Good ball protection.
Bricault shaking up on the play.
Down by number 65. John Owens for the Warriors.
Ball
at the 29-yard line.
Shaking up a bit, kind of holding his eye. It looks like he got poked in the eye or something. Or he might have just got the bell rung a bit. Ball at the 29-yard line. 5:17 to go in the third quarter. This time, man goes back to the shotgun. More comfortable position for him. He's going to roll right and keep. Picks his way ahead, drives ahead. Good strong run by Bruce
Very
Mann.
Strong. This is a good run here. You see it on the replay. He gets on. We get a nice little block out in front by Stevenson. And then he cuts it back inside.
Worked down by Tyler Sanek, but Sanek took the brunt of that hit. 9-yard pickup for Mann. Cook split wide to the left. Stevenson, lone setback. Stevenson takes the handoff, gets the first down. Picks up about 3 on the play. Move the chains.
Ball carry by number 34, Spencer Stevenson for the Chargers.
4:28 to go in the third quarter.
Evan Story for the Warriors.
And Story on the stop for BC Western.
Spencer picks up the first down. It's first and 10 for the Chargers. Okay, 41 right now.
Tight formation. Man, back to pass. Swings it into the backfield and it's dropped. Boy, we've had a few drops tonight. Soraki. Again, it's one of those where he could have caught it in the run. He started running before he had it.
Well, you wait. You're waiting for the ball to get to you, so you get it gets to be a little bit of a problem.
Over 4 minutes remaining. Second and 10. Mann's going to keep it again. Spins ahead, hauled down at the 45. Loses the ball, but the ground caused the fumble. Mann picks up about 4 on the carry. Yep, third and 6. Miller on the stop for Bay City Western. I've been going with more of a tighter formation here in the second half instead of all the wideouts. Ooh, a little Statue of Liberty, and it's going to be a first down and more. Jake Bovee with the carry. A little tricky play there.
It's called a wraparound draw.
Jake Bovee picks up the first down.
Very nicely done.
Yep. Good deception.
Very
by
nice
man.
Block there by Stevenson.
Dow just has a lot of wrinkles in their offense. Just kind of pepper in some odd plays here and there and just keeps you honest. A huge first down for Dow into Western territory at the 43. Man, rolls right, he's gonna keep it again. Picks his way, and he's got the first down and more. There's a flag on the play. He's run out of bounds. There may be a hole downfield, possibly.
Flag on the play.
Good run by Mann once again. Showing some speed out there.
This has been their best running play. Mann yeah. Right or Mann left.
It is going to be holding against Dow. Well downfield. It still may be a first down. Let's see, it's going to be close. Well, they're going to bring it back to the... They're going to put it on the 30. That will be a first down.
First down.
So it didn't cost them the first down. It's costing the yardage. Well, I'll be at the 30. Move the chains once again. .2:45 to go in the third quarter.
This has been a let's take some time off the clock.
Yeah.
Drive.
Two tight end set again. Goes to Guerrier. He shows a nice little move there, and he's going to move the chains. Down to the 20-yard line. Best run of the night by far for Guerrier.
By number
20, Guerrier. Luis Guerrier is a junior.
Down by number 50. Number 58.
It's been a really Excellent drive by Dow via the ground. Cook is going to get it on a little shovel pass, probably technically a pass, but he's going to lose yardage on it. And that's our friend Leon Tobin on the tackle, 2 yard loss. Kind of the equivalent of a jet sweep almost, and sniffed out nicely by Tobin.
That's technically a pass.
Yeah, because he let
throws
go of
it forward.
Right? So
the completion is good, the yardage isn't.
That helped your percentage. Second and 12, 1:45 to go in the third quarter. Here's that wraparound again, and again it's going to go for big yardage. Big yardage, in fact, a touchdown. They ran it left earlier in the drive for a first down. This time, Bovee takes the wraparound and scoots around the right side for Pater. 22-yard touchdown run.
Bovee's got to love this play.
He does.
And a tremendous block out on the perimeter by Cook.
So, outstanding, time-consuming drive by the Chargers.
That was a very good drive.
Time Western jumped. I think Western was offside on this.
Flag on the play.
Might just decline this and just kick a normal extra point.
I don't think you can decline it. I think it's. I always think that you should be able to decline it and the penalty assessed on the kickoff. That's the way it is in college and mm-hmm. pros. In high school, you just move it. Because the play in essence is dead.
Yeah.
Once you jumped off sides.
So we'll line up again. Good snap, good hold, good kick. And Dow High converts, go up 41-21. So whenever BC Western makes a little charge and cuts into that lead, Dow is able to respond. So the whole first half was majority pass, pass, pass. This time it's run, 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 chew up some clock, effectively move down the field.
Two good plays. The wraparound draw gave them big plays. And three Bruce Mann sweeps really took care of that drive.
And so Caleb Brudu will kick off for Dow. Six-eight kicker. One of the taller kickers you're gonna come across. A bit short kick, field at about the 12, and it's gonna go out of bounds. And so, big break for Dow. Lucio Vasquez landing. Tried to feel that and come upfield, but bounced. Unable to corral it, and goes out of bounds. And Bay City has 90 yards to go to Pater.
And that is a perfect kickoff.
Exactly what that was designed to do, I believe. Still rain coming down heavily here at Midland Community Stadium. Pitch to Tobin and nowhere to run. That was Finn with the initial hit and then polished off by Stevenson. Go backwards.
Finn did an excellent job there, holding up the blocker and then getting to the ball carrier, and then Stevenson finished it off. That was excellent defense on the part of Dow.
All back to the 5 yard line, second and 15. This is dangerous territory for Bay City. 51 seconds. You may want to run a play and see if the clock can run out. Tobin going to get some of that back, about probably two yards.
Number 15, Liam Tobin for the Warriors. Cut down by number 15.
Pedro Finn for the Chargers.
Pedro Finn again on the tackle. Third and 13. Would Dow call timeout to... I don't know if Bay City has to run a play here. It'd be... But would Dow call timeout to try to make him kick into the wind?
Well, it's only third down, so
well, that's
they
true,
could run
yeah.
it off.
Yeah. Yeah, Bay City's going to run this out. That will bring the third quarter to an end of our 2016 Dow High homecoming game. Dow High up 41-21. Folks, the coverage of this Midland High football game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on the second Saturday in October. That's October 8th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Or you can come on Saturday, November 12th at the same time. Cost is just $45, which includes the annual access user fee. You can call the number on the screen right there, 837-3474, or come down to the MCTV studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. You can learn more about MCTV at the website listed below, cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV, and you can follow MCTV on Facebook. So, Coach, what's Bay City Western have up their sleeve here? It's dangerous territory in deep, down by three touchdowns, but they got to make something happen. Got to try to see if you can move those chains, but you got to be smart about your play call.
Well, again, you have the wind, but you got receivers a mile out here.
It's on the far hash.
They're not even in the picture. If you can take a look at that. And now we have a trip to the field.
Oh, quick over the middle. That's a nice play call right there to Tobin. And it's going to be close.
The linebackers disappeared. You know, it's third and 13. There's no reason for linebackers to be in so tight. That's a play. That's a linebacker failing right there.
Bay City Western to move the chains. Very nice play call. Again to Tobin, who has just been a huge difference maker for Western. Well thrown ball by Coffey as well. Just picked up enough for the first. Out to the 21-yard line. Coffey back to pass. Fires downfield into no man's land. And there's a flag on the play. Whoa. There were two white jerseys and four green.
Wow.
Maybe he was holding him up?
Personal foul.
Oh, personal foul. Well, that's going to move the chains 15 yards. Yeah, we couldn't really see what happened there, but big penalty. Ball out to the 36-yard line now. .11:20 to go in the game. Coffey going deep, and that ball is almost picked off. Good defensive play by 44. Zeitler was set for the interception, but Grant Fry became a defensive back on that play and prevented the interception.
Okay, now this is offensive interference. We're not going to be able to see it.
Well, he had to do something.
Eight had the ball in his hands.
Yeah. Second and 10. Give credit to that Dow High student section over there. They are hanging steady here in torrential downpour. Same play. And They're going to throw the flag this time on Zeitler. Boy. So another Dow penalty. It's going to be pass interference. Kind of ran the same play, roll reversal there. It was going to be pretty tough for Fry to catch that one.
Pass interference called against the Chargers.
And the chains move once again. The Westerns picked up one first down on their own and a couple via penalty. And they are inside Dow territory. Ball at the 49-yard line. Coffee back to pass. Hitch and go, and he's got his man. Going to be another first down. Tobin once again of the big play. Hitch and go, that wasn't Tobin, it was Miller. Nice play, good pass, but it's gonna be a hold on Bay City Western. Wow, so there are a couple big calls that went Western's way this time.
Dow was very fortunate there. The Dow defender got turned around, committed when the ball wasn't even in the air, he committed. Well, one thing you learn is, you know, always back off. Back off until you're sure where the ball is.
Great route by Miller. But the spot foul is going to make it first and 23. Maybe 24. With just over 11 minutes to go in the game. Cuffy back. Throws it out of the backfield. Oh, that's a great defensive play by Zeitler. Had potential for big yardage to Vasquez Landon, but nice stick by Zeitler.
Brought down by number 8, Ben Zeitler for the Chargers.
Not real big, just
5'8", 155. Yeah.
Put his nose in it, though.
He's one of my junior golfers.
Is he?
Yeah, way long time ago. It's hard for me to believe that he's out here sticking his nose in there. But he's a tough kid, very tough.
Second and 22 for Western. Coffee goes deep, nothing doing there. Another flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
You're going to let me call a defensive holding on that one. But triple coverage.
Pass interference.
Man.
Pass interference called against the Chargers.
The laundry has been flying in this quarter.
The offensive receiver ran into Zeitler. And you just got to give him room.
Second and 6. Was the first and 24.
The game has gotten very sloppy here in the fourth quarter. Very sloppy.
It's a lot of big penalties both ways.
Let them throw short passes. Get back. You're going to throw an interception. Just sit back and wait for it. I do not understand, and this is a rule. We always had a zone defense for nights like this because that's exactly what's going to happen. Just take care of your zone. He's going to throw it up in the air.
Well, it was incomplete. It was intended for Myers. Dobin stayed in the backfield that time. Nice job picking up the blitz. But just underthrown by Coffey. He'll bring up a 3rd and 6. Got to get to the 39-yard line. Multiple substitutions for Dow. .10:06 remaining in the fourth quarter. Dow High with touchdown lead.
The play I'm going to run is back out of the backfield. Been the most successful. Dow's linebackers have yet to pick it up. They usually have run it to the left side, so it would be up to Finn to protect it. I'm just saying, that's my call right now. It's the safest call I have.
Western calls timeout. They certainly have run that play successfully.
Right.
And it's a well-conceived play, and Western's been able to execute it. The timeout is probably letting Coach Watkins talk about that very play and what the assignments are.
They ran one time they ran it into the flat, and the other time they ran it out of the backfield over the middle. But it's still the back out of the backfield.
Tobin, maybe?
Of course.
He's a senior. Now, hi, coaching staff, along with Coach Watkins. You can look on your screen and see playback times of this game coming up in the near future. And more times will be posted on the website you see below, midlandps.org. Third and six for Western. Picks up the block. It's open. He's got the first. Oh, he dropped it. Whoa, he had it. Nice play. There's a flag on the play. I think it's going to be roughing the passer. Oh, it's a hit to the head of the quarterback. Another big penalty. That was on third down. Stevenson just.
That was truly an unnecessary penalty. The ball was gone.
Should have been a first down, but he just plain dropped it. So roughing the passer, there's been a lot of penalty yardage on this drive. 9:59 remaining. Coffey did take a shot on that when he released the ball. Well thrown ball by Coffey, gotta give him credit, under heavy duress. First and 10, Bay City Western from the Dow High 30. Coffey back to pass, rolls left. Fires downfield, overthrown. You sort of expect a flag almost, I hate to say it. But did a pretty good job getting rid of the ball. He was rolling left and tried to launch it to the middle of the field, overthrew his man, and fell harmlessly incomplete. Second and 10 for Western. Quick pitch to Tobin. Got a little bit of room, but gap filled
good
nicely.
Run,
that was
good fill.
That was Zeitler once again. He's been heavily into the action in this drive as Zeitler. Every which way. It's going to be third and six for Western. At the wind of their back. That steady rain still coming down here at Midland Community Stadium. Gotta be a flag. The flanker jumped. I'll bring it back to third and 11. That's a big penalty for Western to incur.
Boy, the officials have had a workout this drive,
oh my
haven't
gosh.
They?
It's paid by the penalty. They're gonna get a bonus. That was a clear. An obvious call there. Third and 11 for Western from the 31. This is certainly going to be two down territory. Down by three scores. Coffey back to pass. Tries the hitch and go again. Goes deep. And that ball is, dropped. He had it at the 1 yard line. Another flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
This one should be holding.
Yeah, I think it's going to be. It would have come back anyway.
Yeah.
Do you decline this one?
No.
It would be fourth and 11 or third and 21. Take it.
Take it.
And Coach Watkins heeds your advice and takes it. So now third.
Again, working on field position. Don't want to give him anything down there.
Well, when you do this, they have to get two plays of 10 yards instead of one.
Right.
So it makes perfect sense.
And I have a better chance now of intercepting.
Because they're going to try to throw it a little deeper.
Sure they are.
A lot of penalties on this drive. Two receivers out to the right. Coffee back to pass. Kind of fakes a little screen. He's going to go deep and intercepted. You called that one, Coach. He intended for
exactly. I mean, that's
Bellinger.
Exactly what's going to happen. Recall made the interception. Good play. You kind of expect that's going to happen.
Yeah, you called it.
You got to throw
interception.
You
got to
do something else. You got to throw a screen, maybe even a draw play there, something that is going to get you half the distance so you can come back and get the other half. The 10-yard penalty was monumental there. I mean, that was a great accepting of the penalty.
Bricault with the interception for Dow. And after all of that, Western turns it over, and Dow gets the ball again. Oh, big play on D. Guerrier was the ball carrier, and Tobin with the stop.
Guerrier is not running the ball with the same enthusiasm that I've seen him all year long. He looks like he's picking his holes. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's really a good running back. But he's not showing it tonight.
Second and 10. He just run the ball twice and then try to get a first just to chew up some clock. Could see man with the carry here. Drops the ball. He's going to pick his way ahead. Makes a lot out of nothing. Heady play by Bruce Mann for 8 yards.
Bounced right up in his hands again.
Does a good job picking his way into.
See the number of arm. See the arm tackles. This is what's happened to Western in this whole game. Arm tackles. And it hasn't been that. There's only been one or two really good solid hits.
7 minutes to go in the ball game. Dow High in control here. And the 28. Really, the clock is their greatest ally. Man's going to keep it. Oh, that time he got stuck.
That was a good tackle.
Going to be short of the first.
That was a good tackle by Ross Patterson.
Ross Patterson and Brody Lewis, the big hit. And bring up fourth down. It is absolutely pouring right now.
If Dow doesn't kick, they're going to try to get him to jump.
Probably not going to get a ton out of a punt, would they? But still a ball in the 29. Man's going to keep it. And it's going to get it, I'm pretty sure. Yep, they're going to give him the spot. Really hard to stop him on that play. The gamble pays off for Coach Watkins. Dow will move the chains and, more importantly, move the clock. 6 minutes to go. Coach Watkins and his staff, which includes Lee Kamen, Phil Igeb, Matt Peterson, John Streeter, and Steve Watkins, are looking to secure victory number 6 on the year. And they are certainly in the driver's seat.
To me, I'm looking at a 6-minute drive. Yep. That's exactly what you need to think here. Run the clock.
It's hard to envision a pass at this time. Man drives ahead. And they pick up about 4. And gonna kill some more clock.
Bruce Mayer on the keeper for the Chargers.
Yeah, it is absolutely pouring now, and they're going into the wind. You just got to chew up that clock. They get 5 yards of crack.
I couldn't believe the weather could get worse, but it has gotten worse.
It sure has.
We had that little window of opportunity for about a minute.
Quite a few folks still sticking this one out. Pretty much all the Bay City Western fans that came are still over there. Guerrier on the tack, on the carry. He's hit hard and kind of was trying to dance his way through. He's going to maybe get a yard. Third and four. Four and a half to go here in the quarter on homecoming as Dow is really firm control to try to get this homecoming victory. Again, congrats to homecoming king Ben Price and homecoming queen Nadia Atten. Celebrate homecoming just a little bit more. Man, back to pass. And that ball is
caught.
Complete. Cook
nice
can
catch.
Lose the chains.
Nice catch. Yeah.
He went down real low to secure right. That one. He doesn't get it. It stops the clock. But another first down. We're under 4 minutes to go. That was a nice job.
The wind and gravity have taken over. I think the thing that saved that was it still had great tone on the ball.
Yeah. Yeah. Bovee now in the backfield where Stevenson moves up to the wing. Time Dow jumped. Send them back 5 yards with 3:30 remaining. Kind of unusual. Poor guy jumped and went right into his teammate and knocked him over. Laugh about that a little bit more when you have a 20-point lead
yes,
with 3 minutes
exactly,
to go.
Exactly, exactly.
There's Stevenson. Be the lone setback. First and 15. Oh, they jumped again.
Flag on the play.
And Bovee. Ball
start called against the Chargers.
First and 20 now.
Well, the worst part of this is, Dave, that the clock is running, and I don't know why the clock is running.
On the penalty, it would stop, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I would think so.
Otherwise, Dow could just keep doing that and never run a play. Man keeps it, and he's gone. Fake the handoff to Guerrier, and a brilliant play by Man. Then he kept it with the left end.
I was fooled. I thought Guerrier had the ball.
I did, too. I was calling
that beautiful fake. Beautiful fake.
I think most of the people watching this game thought Guerrier had that ball, including Bay City Western, because you look at that, and there was just nobody there. So, Man, his first rushing touchdown of the day. And going to get 66 yards on the score. And go for the extra point. It's Man's fourth touchdown rushing on the season. Extra point's good. And the Dow lead bumps up to 48-21. Everybody's pursued to Gary A. And man, Werner on the end, he's nothing but green in front of him. Well, if it wasn't over then, I have to say it is now, coach. Dow High is going to improve to 6-0 on the season, 5-0 in league play, and they just punched their ticket to the postseason.
Exactly. Now the question is, where in the postseason? You know, you got to continue to win.
Three more games.
You figure a 9-0 or an 8-1 will get you a first round home game. They've got a difficult task coming up against Flint Carmen Ainsworth.
And of course, we'll end against our tribal Midland High in the annual city championship game. Pooch kick, and nobody fields it. Finally, they do, but struggled with that, that little pooch kick as Western. Corralled there by Vasquez Landon. 1:59 to go in the ball game.
You would think 3 weeks ago when they played Midland pooch kicked every kickoff. And you would think, okay, after that, I have a pretty good idea of what to do and where to place the players.
Well, they lost. They turned it over on one of those exact plays earlier in the game.
Correct.
Cost them 6-7 points. Gonna hand it off. He'd be waving the white flag here. Ball is handed off to Jared Gosselin. Well, you give Western credit. They fought, scratched, and clawed the whole game, but Dow just too much. Too much offense.
Well, this is the best effort I've seen out of Western. I thought a couple weeks ago they had very little effort, and but, you know, they did put 21 points up on the board. They did play hard, and they have not given up.
No. So, but, you know, that was run defense for the most now, part was very solid.
You can see the weakness in Western is their run offense. You know, they're last in their league. They're last in the entire league in run offense.
Real big high point for them was the play of Liam Tobin. Had a tremendous game on both sides of the ball. Bruce Mann with another big game, 4 touchdown passes, gives him 16 on the year. Also running touchdown. Big stick by Brent Booth for Dow. And that's gonna do it. Under 20 seconds.
Excuse me, number 25, Hunter Clipper.
Fourth down.
And I'm just gonna let it run
let
out.
Let it run out.
Dow's gonna be tough to beat, coach.
Dow is tough to beat.
They have playmakers. They execute on both sides of the ball. They have some tremendous talent. And the tall receivers are going to be tough to handle.
And on a good night, man is better than most. Better than most.
Had a pretty good statistical, off a little bit, but you got to know.
I have no problems with what tonight. I thought he had it for the weather and the conditions and the wind. I thought he played very, very well. Got to be very proud of himself because he made most of the big runs.
Yeah.
He gave Dow the run offense that they needed. Bay City Western is going to have a very unsuccessful year unless they can get their run game sorted out. I thought their quarterback did well.
Mm-hmm.
Not great, but well. But their run game is just awful.
Western will fall to 2-4 overall, 2-3 in the league. And Dow, as you mentioned, improves to 6-0 on the season. And before we, as the players shake hands, we'll take a look at some of the second half highlights here coming up. That was from the first half. That was a touchdown by Fabiano, touchdown reception. Similar play, the second score for Dow, also in the first half, to Stredney.
And then this is the pitch pass.
Tobin to Miller. And went for the hitch, and when he went, he was gone. Made it 13-7. Right there, at that point in time, it looked like they were gonna be dead in the water. That was a huge play for Western. And then another pass over the middle to Cook from Mann. And then the swing pass out to Stevenson for the fourth TD.
That was a great play by both of them. And then this is the back out of the backfield. Covered and then uncovered.
That was right towards the end of the half. Right. A really, really impressive drive by Bay City Western to keep it a ball game. And then they started the second half with this play here. Pick six by Stredney. And when that happened, he just knew it was going to be trouble for Western. Here's the fumble by Dow that led to Western's third score. Coming up a slant pass. Touchdown to Fry from Coffey.
That was a good pass.
And there's that wraparound.
Draw to Bovey.
Yep, Bovey had two big gains on that same play. One to the left and the touchdown to the right. And this was...
This is the interception.
The interception
by Brokaw.
And then here's that fake handoff. He put it in his belly. People bit. 42 saw it, but it was too late. By the time he reacted, a man was off to the races to give us the final score, 48-21. And so Coach Watkins, post-game talk to his team. One of those were certain things you can improve on, but you've got to be proud of his team and this adverse conditions to win one on homecoming and improve to 6-0 and earn a spot to the postseason. And so we're going to wrap it up here. Again, the final score, Dow 48, Bay City Western 21. Homecoming victory for the Chargers. Again, this is Dave Marsh and Frank Aldemore. Happy to bring you the action, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Good night, everybody.